Having looked at the chemistry of monosaccharides in some detail, we're now ready to move on to some more complex sugar chemistry that involves the joining together of monosaccharides. If we join two monosaccharides together, like the structures that you see on this page, we'd be talking about disaccharides. Two monosaccharides coming together makes a disaccharide. Three or more monosaccharides coming together makes the oligosaccharide, and if we are talking about bringing together a large number of monosaccharides, we're talking about the polysaccharides. You can see that basic structure of the disaccharides, many of them are common to you, such as maltose, cellulose, the cellobiose, which is the building block of cellulose, and sucrose. You can see basically what we're talking about is two monosaccharides that are joined together by this glycosidic bond. And notice that in one case, what we have is the acetal functional group, that is, the anomeric carbon of the sugar on the left-hand side of this disaccharide has the functional group where at the C1 position of the acetal functional group, whereas on the right-hand side, that sugar has the hemiacetal, since it has the hydroxyl group there. Really what we want to do in this webcast is set up the idea of structure elucidation of disaccharides, and let's do that with a common sugar, lactose. We'll return to the disaccharides that are seen here in a later webcast, but for now, what we want to do is just take and examine in great detail one disaccharide, and that disaccharide is one you're familiar with. It's lactose from milk. So basically, lactose, like many other disaccharides, is a sugar that has a multiple of 6 carbon atoms, and the reason is because disaccharides are often formed from hexoses. Hexoses, two of them come together, or two or more, will have an integer number of 6 carbon atoms involved in the formula, and lactose is a C12 disaccharide. So in other words, it's a hexose dimer, and when we subject that to hydrolysis, recalling that the glycosidic bond, that acetal bond that I pointed out on the previous slide, is going to be broken under these hydrolysis conditions, then we're going to end up making the two monosaccharide building blocks, and in the case of lactose, one obtains D-glucose and D-galactose. Now, if you remember, these two sugars are actually very similar. They're identical structures in that they're hexoses, and the only thing that differs about them is their stereochemistry at C4. They're epimers at C4, and so these are basically two hexoses differing only by that one stereochemical position. Now, our question is, and what we want to set up for the next webcast, is what's the structure of lactose? We only know what its building blocks are. We don't know anything else about the structure, and that's what we're going to determine in the next webcast. And let me, for you, in the remainder of this webcast, simply set up the problem that we're going to have to examine in the next webcast. So we know, based on what I just showed you, that the hydrolysis conditions break apart lactose into two sugar molecules, glucose and galactose. But what we don't know is which sugar is on the left, that is, which one of the sugars is connected as its anomeric carbon with that acetal functional group. We don't know specifically whether this stereochemistry should be up or down. That would determine whether it's glucose or galactose here on the left-hand side. And then the other thing we don't know, the second point we don't know, is which of the sugar's hydroxyl groups on the right-hand side is attached. There's at least four hydroxyl groups which could be connected to that sugar on the left. So that's the second issue that we don't know. And then the third issue that we don't know would be this issue of the stereochemistry at the alpha or beta position. Specifically, we don't know whether or not at that anomeric position on that left-hand side sugar, whether it's axial or equatorial, axial being alpha, equatorial being beta.